Hi, I'm Hannah Hembry Bell, founding attorney at the Hembry Bell Law Firm. And today we're going to talk money, honey. Believe it or not, I want to help you save money in your divorce process. So we'll talk through four key strategies you can employ that will directly impact your bottom line. Number one, batch your questions. Now, when you're getting divorced or you're dealing with a custody situation or even an adoption, questions are going to come to you all of the time, but I'm going to ask you, do not email your paralegal or your lawyer or your legal assistant every single time you have a question. Your bill is going to begin to mount up very quickly because most law firms bill by the hour, and that's in increments of time, even tenths of hours. And you don't want them to bill you every single time there's a question because it's going to add up. So if instead you start a note on your phone or on your computer and think of those questions and write them down as they come to you, and then schedule a time with your legal team to walk through those questions at once, it will save you money. And hey, pro tip, even better, email your team those questions in advance so everyone is super prepared and is really efficient with their time. That's going to save you money on your bottom line, guaranteed. Number two, organize your documents. This is, I should like have a neon sign. This is be organized. If you keep all of your stuff organized, you will save your legal team the necessity to organize them for you. And I know it's a pain in the butt, and most of us do not want to sit through and, you know, save everything through some certain protocol. But if you don't do it, your legal team's going to do it for you. And they're going to bill you to do it, right? Because this is how we earn our living. They're going to bill you to get it all organized. So if from the beginning, you figure out from your team, how do they need things structured? How do they organize files at that firm? And then you do it, you will save yourself so much money and improve the efficiency of your case moving along. Number three, be reasonable. Now, this one falls into the category of easier said than done. Look, I'm preaching to myself here because I've been there. And it is hard. I mean, you're divorcing this person or you're having a custody battle with them for a reason. And that stirs up all kinds of emotions. And you can get tempted to do things for spite or for revenge or on the principle of the matter. But when your emotions are driving the train, your bill will necessarily go up, I promise you. So do your best to keep a cool head. Take some time to reflect and ask yourself the question, you know, so what? It's a handy rule of thumb to have in your case. Ask yourself, so what? So what if this is true? So what if this happens? How is that going to impact the overall success of my family moving forward? To try to maintain an equilibrium. And when you do that, when it's equilibrium, not emotions, you will save money in your case. The fourth way you're going to save money in your divorce is keep focused on a win-win. If you've done any kind of communication training, you know in difficult conversations and situations, you're supposed to try to get to a win-win where both parties get something they can live with and they're comfortable with and maybe even see as a win out of the situation. Often in divorce, though, that's not how people come into the situation. They want a winner and a loser, and they want to be the winner. If you do that and you have that zero-sum win-lose mentality, it's going to cost you more money in divorce because you're going to fight more. You're going to end up in court more. It's just going to increase your fees. So keep laser focused in this process on negotiation of compromise and coming to a deal that's best for your family. It's going to save you not only money, but heartache in terms of the level of drama with your case. But I can guarantee it'll keep your bottom line as low as possible. Look, nobody gets divorced because it's a sound financial decision. There's a cost of doing business here. But if you follow these four key strategies, you will keep your bottom line as low as possible. If you'd like to discuss getting started with our firm or develop some more strategies for how we can keep your costs down, give us a call or shoot us an email. We look forward to hearing from you.